here's the project today. We've got a 2017 Honda Civic LX. We're going to change out the horns because the OEM horn is the meek horn. It's terrible. And we're going to install a set of fog lights. This will involve removing the front bumper cover. We're going to show you how to do that. We have some basic tools here to use to remove the front cover. I've also got a test light that'll be for putting the new horns in later. But your main tools are going to be 10 millimeter socket, a 5 millimeter Allen. Now, yeah, obviously, you can use just a $2 5 millimeter Allen wrench, or you can use a socket like this. This bumper is held in by a series of clips, and this I found has been a good tool for removing those clips, mostly without breaking them. Some of them are very difficult not to break. You have to be careful. This is a paint can opener, and it's actually a certain style of clip. Honda uses, I don't know, 20 different styles of clips on these cars. I don't know why they just couldn't go with a standardized clip, but to remove many of the clips in taking off the bumper cover, I found this tool to be very, very useful in starting to pop up the clip and get it off without breaking it. And then some of this stuff is just generic, a pair of vice grips. A flashlight is very handy to have, especially when working underneath the car, because you have clips underneath the car. And then on the horn installation, of course, I got my black electrical tape, if I can get that. Okay, this is the horn kit that I'm going to use. It's a simple Hella kit, two horns, high and low, 12 volt. It's a twin tone trumpet horn. I see on the internet where some people install air horns in there and all kinds of fancy sounds in their Civics, which is great for them. But for me, I just want a decent horn that we've been used to for decades, a dual tone horn, a standard horn on many, many cars over the decades. As you can see, I've got the front of the car set up for removing the bumper cover. There's blue tape. I put blue tape around the headlights, because the headlights do not come out with the bumper. And there are clips in between the headlights and the bumper cover that you have to get in there and pop out. And it can either damage the bumper or cover or damage the headlight. And if you have the blue protective tape on there, there's less of a chance of doing that. So I've got myself set up. I've got drop cloths and some knee pads, because I'm going to be lying on the ground to get to all of the connectors and bolts underneath the on the bottom of the bumper cover. There's 7 clips, plastic clips, 2 10 millimeter bolts, and 2 5 millimeter Allen bolts that separate the bottom of the bumper cover from the car. There's 3 types of clips used on these front bumper covers. This is the first type. It's a push pin clip, when it's seated, the top pin is in and it spreads out. And in order to undo these clips, I've found that this little paint tool is excellent. You just get the corner in there, you lift up, and basically you go around, and then you can pull the top out, and then the clip will be released. Turning it half a turn while you're releasing it helps. And I've discovered that doing it this way, generally you don't break these clips. Although these clips are like 50 cents each, they're cheap. The next type of clip is just a simple push pin. It just pushes in and pops out. And these clips, I've discovered, really are pretty hardy. They don't break. And they're used to hold the engine rubber seal in. There's 6 of them. And then the other type of clip, and I find that these are the worst. These have a tendency to break. They're difficult to get out. There's 2 of these that goes on the rubber engine seal at the end. It's the engine compartment seal. It's not a seal in the engine. They go at the very end on left and right side of the these will come out with this tool, but they're difficult to maneuver. And once you get the top started, you get the other side started, and if you're lucky, you can pull the top up, but it's they're in there good, that top. And so that's where this is a new tool that I wanted to show you to add to the collection of tools that I'm using here. This has got a plastic end for depressing clips around the headlights without breaking them. But if you can get the top up, then you can slip this one under, pop it all the way out, and then if you're lucky, you can get this last clip out without breaking it. Like I said, luckily these clips are very inexpensive. It's just, you know, the pain in the ass of having to drive to the Honda dealer to buy them. And I bought some extras. I just don't want to be bothered doing a job and then not finishing it correctly. This is the new tool. Any parts store, auto parts store, should have this tool, and they're cheap. They're generally in the body department, you know, where all the Bondo and spray paint and different body repair. Other people use a tool like this too, which is says it's a door panel remover, but it can be used, you know, to slip under there and pop up the cap to get these plastic clips out. This was only $5, and I bought it, and just because I thought, on the chance that I actually would need to use it. The next step Gonna get the next connector out, pin rather, the next pin out. And I've got just a little bucket here to put them in so I don't end up losing them. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's 10 of these style clips that hold this big plastic shield on. Alright, so I've got all the clips out. Luckily I didn't break any, but like I said, I have extras and they're like 50 cents each. They're at the Honda dealer, they're cheap. And then what comes off next is this plastic shield that goes over the front of the engine. So we're going to put that aside. So the next thing to remove is this engine rubber seal. You probably heard that popping noise on these small clips that hold the rubber seal in, and it almost sounds like they break, but as you can see, they don't break. They're kind of tough, and I did buy a couple of extras of these just in case they did break, but generally I've found that these ones don't break. They're tough. And there's three on each side that hold the rubber seal in. So now we'll get the they didn't break, and here's the rubber seal that we're going to put aside. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put three of these style clips back in the top. I'm going to put one in here. I'm going to put one in the middle. As you can see, sometimes these can be tricky, but you have to get them seated. And I'm not going to push the pin down. I'm just using these to help hold the top of this bumper cover, because once I remove everything from the bottom and the sides, and I'm going to want to lift the bumper cover off, I don't want it to fall, even though I've got protection here on the ground. These three pins will just temporarily hold the top of the bumper cover in while I'm unclipping everything else. The next thing I want to show is I've set up a couple of sawhorses and covered them. And when I take the bumper cover, front bumper cover off, that's what I'm going to rest the bumper cover on, because I don't want it to get scratched on the bottom or risk being damaged. And I also, I'm going to have to be working on it, because as I said, this project is upgrading the horns and putting a fog light kit in it. Next, I want to show you the part numbers for those clips. I want to show a little bit, if I can, of the underside, where you'll be removing three clips from the front and the middle, two clips over on the side, and then two clips over on the driver's side. And then there's the 5mm Allen bolt and the 5mm Allen bolt. And then at the very far ends of the bumper cover on the underneath is a 10mm. That's the socket size to remove it. A 10mm on this side and a similar one on the passenger side. Okay, I've removed the plastic clips first. There's two out here, three in the middle here, and then two on the other outer edge. It's right here. It's a long bolt, which I don't understand why. As you can see, I got the two 10mm bolts out. Seven of these push type connectors, the most common ones, I took them out. There's three in the middle, and then two on the passenger side and two on the driver's side. The only other thing left to do to finish disconnecting the bottom of the cover is to remove the two Allen screws. The first Allen screw is right here. You just break it loose, and you don't have to have a socket and a wrench. You can just do it with a cheap $2 Allen wrench. But I happen to have this. And here's the bolt. You can see that it's got a shoulder on it. When we go to put the cover back and reassemble it, I'll show you how to get these started first and then finish up installing the cover. Okay, so now we're at the other Allen bolt on the passenger side. I'm going to break that loose and then just unbolt it. And then that finishes the bottom of the bumper cover. Okay, so we're done with the bottom of the bumper cover. The last two that I took out were the two Allen screws with the shoulder. They have a shoulder on them. It turned out that this tool is very handy. They're not expensive at all, under $5, and you'll find that they're, and then this thing was like 60 cents over at Home Depot, I think, or something. I use it to open paint cans, but I discovered that it works really well on these push pin type plastic clips. Continuing on our front bumper cover removal project on a 2017 Civic, the next step is to remove the side marker light. And a lot of people skip this step, I've noticed, but I found that it just makes everything go so much easier. So you pry back a little bit on this rubber piece. There's a spring, and that's what's holding the clip in, and you have to depress. You have to depress on on these three things. Disconnect the electrical connector. One end just has a hook that goes in there. And then I put these aside. Some people just leave them hanging off the car. But I just put them aside. The next step is to remove these two Phillips screws. Now I'm still on the passenger side of the bumper, and I'm going to depress with that plastic tool these little tabs here. There's two under there, and then where I've got the tape, there's two more that you need to okay. So once you've got this part pulled away, we're gonna go do the same thing on the other side, the driver's side. Okay, I'm going to remove the side marker light the same way I did on the other side. Side marker removed. The wheel well. These are the two screws. They're almost like just like sheet metal screws. Now we're going to press down. We're getting close. As you'll remember, I had the three clips temporarily in here up top to make sure that this bumper just, when I went to pull it off, it just wasn't going to come flying off and get all scratched and everything. Okay, so we're going to get into one of the trickiest parts of this. As you can see where I've got the blue tape, there's tabs similar to the ones on the edge here that you have to depress to pull the bumper away. The bumper cover, it's not the bumper. And it's the same thing on this side. We've got tabs here. So now we're getting ready to pull the bumper cover off and lay it on the sawhorses. The two last tabs are clips that need to be pulled. Are these right here. What they do is they hold this very top piece on, and you just access them with a simple flat blade screwdriver. Push down on them until you hear them pop loose, and then you can see that this little chrome piece pops loose. I'm going to remove the bumper cover now. Taken off the two. taking off the last one. There's a bumper cover removed and put up on the sawhorses.